The End is a new documentary about London's gangsters set in the East End. The film The End was made by Les Falco's twin daughters, Nicola and Teena Collins. Hi, I'm here with Alison Poltop and she's going to tell us a little bit about the East End Festival.
Okay, well the East End Film Festival was set up 8 years ago, primarily as a platform for local filmmakers. There's a lot of talent in the area and it's evolved over the last few years to become an international festival, so we're really proud to have The End.
You know, I was searching for inspiration for the next film, and you always go back to your doorstep, I think, you know. That's what inspired me the most, is where I come from. So I decided to do a film about my dad and his friends. It took me 6 weeks to shoot the film, but then it took, I would say, 3.5 years to finish this film, so it was a long time. Well, it's a different response in each place, isn't it, really? You know, like in America, they love it, you know, it's something that they've never seen or something they don't know. We've had a great reaction wherever. The best reaction in America, probably.
We didn't really expect this at all, you know. Like, we thought we'd submit it to a few film festivals and see how it goes. We didn't dream that, you know, it would be out on DVD and in theatres.
Yeah, it's the premiere for the new cut, but to be honest with you, we've done so many screenings now. It's like... Yeah. This is exciting though. This is the opening night of East End Film Festival. You know, the film's come home. It makes sense, so, you know, it'll be a good night. Yes, we're actually, I'm directing and Tina's producing. It's a script by David Lynch's daughter, Jennifer Lynch, and it's actually about twins. So, something very close to our hearts.
Right, I'm going to go inside and watch this film. Okay, so we've just come out of the film, The End, and we're going to get some people's opinions on what they thought of it. So, did you enjoy the film?
Yeah, I loved it. Yeah, it was great hearing the stories, you know. It's a shame there's a lot of stuff that they couldn't talk about, yeah. I'd like to hear that, because the stuff that they didn't talk about was so funny and brought back the old times, you know, they're obviously gone now. It's quite melancholy in a way, you know. It's a lot of it was reminiscent, and if you live in the East End like I do, it's all kind of relevant.
Yeah. Okay guys, what did we think of the film?
I thought it was fantastic. I loved it actually. Very simple, just love the way they just opened up and... Yeah, it's really honest.
Yeah, it's
really good actually.
Yeah.
Really good, yeah.
And what did you think of it?
It was really compelling. It just kind of kept drawing me in a lot actually. I was expecting it to go into a lot more detail, but actually just the repetition, storytelling and so on, just the little hints of things being unsaid especially were really kept me sort of paying attention. Obviously there's a few of the guys here tonight. Very good, thank you.
Did you think the film glamorised being a gangster? Do you think it glamorised the lifestyle, guns, you know, money, jail? Do you think it glamorised it,
It didn't intend to glamorise it. I mean, that's something that they spoke about themselves. But we glamorise it. It's not the fault of the filmmakers or the gangsters themselves. They don't glamorise it. We as an audience do, you know. They are so far removed from your normal everyday Joe, you know, that you know, we can't help holding them in some sort of, you know, awe, you know. Because their lives are so different, you know, than most people's lives. So we glamorise it.
Do you think the film glamorised being a gangster?
Well, there's always a slight attraction with the whole gangster thing, isn't there? I mean, why was all of their favourite, you know, film characters Robert De Niro?
Yeah.
I mean, their DVD collection must be really small. But I don't know. There's glamour there, but I mean, they weren't glamorous guys. They were just guys. So no, they seem quite honest. I don't think that film was glamorising the gangster lifestyle at all. I mean, after all, one of them was just stood in a field the entire time. I mean, that's, you know, presumably because that's where he hides now. I don't know.